on, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you are having a fantastic
day.
So yeah, the news is we got these fools all the way out from Canada visiting. We're going down to Orange County today.
How you guys doing? We're gonna have fun.
Let's go. If you guys missed yesterday's video, I don't know, why are you yelling? You gotta yell.
We're at Starbucks, everybody.
I showed pictures of the leaked BMW 8 Series. Make sure to check that out. Those that don't know, this is Dave.
Hey.
Sometimes he's funny, so they keep him around. We're not really sure other than that. This is Dad Oliver. He races bikes. He doesn't like being called Dad Oliver. And then this is Damon.
What's up?
He's got a supercharged Huracan.
What up, guys?
It's pretty legit. Damon is basically the reason that I have a supercharged Huracan. He supercharged his. It's rear-wheel drive.
He asked me, did it have any problems? I said, no, it's had no problems. Never, ever, ever. And you're like, sounds too good to be true. I was like, it's basically a pyramid scheme, VF engineering.
No, it turns out it's not too good to be true.
Ooh, it's a Model 3.
He looks like a Model 3 owner.
He's like, why are you walking?
The commute traffic this morning is absolutely ridiculous. I think we've gone about a mile in the last 25 minutes.
They want a good shot of Parker's kid. There you go. Yeah.
Turbo S, that thing's sexy. Like Chevy actually invented Volcano Orange before McLaren did. It looks like a 720S. All right, Damon just made the craziest comparison of all time. What did you just say the new Vantage looks like?
The Miata.
All right, after serious time, I mean, you spent the last 20 minutes trying to stitch these pictures together.
Ah, damn. Oh, shoot, guys. That's like, it's like somewhat accurate. Oh, no.
What have you done? You just ruined the car for me.
I mean, of course, they're not the same car, but at a glance, if you really wanted to be that way.
Dude, you just need to Photoshop the Miata in yellow and it could be pretty close.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
like, if it was
damn.
The same color, it would be even worse.
Damn.
That is the most depressing comparison of all time, especially because I think the new Aston looks super beautiful. Although I actually like the way the new Miata looks as well. Comment in the comment section below. What do you think? Similar or not?
Yeah.
Whoop, whoop, whoop.
You gonna do another running from the cop stage prank?
Yeah.
Cop is fully not trying to pull anyone over. He just put his lights on, is driving in the shoulder to beat the LA traffic.
He's trying to get to Randy's donuts.
What is going on in here?
Hold on. Turn on the windshield wiper.
Dude, look at your sunshades. That's ridiculous. Is it even safe to drive like this? I thought Damon was like kind of dumb, but he brought $50,000 of fake money across international borders and found out afterwards that yeah, it's a huge felony. What was the thought process behind that?
Well, you shipped it, so I thought it was okay, and then I never thought to just bring it back on us would be a
just
problem.
Just on the plane?
Yeah, and then we found out Anthony, literally our buddy from Mad Whips,
yeah,
sent me a text and was like, you know it's totally illegal to bring money across, like fake money across the border. And I was like, come on, it's fake. Like, why would it be a problem? And it ends up being that it can only be one third the size and only one sided. And if you look at these bills, they're true to size.
Yeah.
Double sided. So it's considered counterfeit money.
The crazy thing is it actually looks super, super real and feels real too. The only difference is it says for motion picture use only. It turns out they're really good sunshades because this Q3, yeah, it doesn't come with them. You just have 10K just sitting up there on the dash.
Can you imagine you got pulled over right now?
The cop's like, your field of vision is obstructed.
You'd be like, is this really gonna be a problem?
Bribing a cop with counterfeit money, that's a good idea. We are headed to VF Engineering right now to check out the supercharged I can't even, I thought Canadians were nice. I didn't know they were douchebags.
How is this douchey?
Look at yourself. Seriously though, a supercharged Performante is the car to have. Already a beast around the track, doesn't have nearly as much power as a 720S, but with the supercharger, that thing's gonna destroy lap times. Look at that, boys. We got a Sentra Nismo. Finally, after like 4 hours, we are pulling up to VF Engineering. This traffic. All right, we just showed up to VF Engineering, and look who's here. We got Sam, who is a beast of a driver. You were in my video a while back. Is now supercharged. How do you like it, man?
I love it.
You love it? We got the supercharged Huracan squad.
Yeah, we are.
He has a drift handbrake, so like.
I do. I mean,
yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Didn't you do something with your tires? You put thinner tires on a more powerful
car? We were just talking about it, yeah.
Really?
We put 285s because it just makes it easier to slide around and drift and have fun compared to like a 305 or 315, which I run normally.
Yeah.
With some low, you know, lower tread wear. You know, I have 315s and TO1 from NATO tires for grippy days.
Yeah.
And then I put this NT555s on four, basically slide around and fun.
The video that we filmed of him drifting into this went absolutely viral all over Instagram. That was sick.
We're gonna do some more tricks today.
Look how sexy this thing is. Full Vorsteiner kit, supercharged with the handbrake, rear wheel drive, thinner tires. What do we got in the shop here today? So there's this beautiful dark matte gray RS7 and a stunning white Performante. I am so excited to see these Performantes hit the streets. This is honestly the ultimate hypercar killer. My car with the supercharger, obviously incredibly fast, but with a car that can lap the Nürburgring in under 7 minutes stock, imagine with a supercharger how damn good this is gonna be around the track. This is really cool. They've painted the supercharger to match that goldish bronze color of the stock Performante. What do you think about it?
I think it's beautiful. So part of the active aero, air's forced through these channels into here. So when this closes, this lines up with the edge of this. I just learned this from Nick, so I'm repeating what he said. this section of air is pushed down towards the exhaust, always. Yep. And if you look on this side, there's actually a servo in there that actuates this valve. And has certain conditions and speeds and all that stuff, it'll open up to push air up through the spoiler.
Now, one of the coolest parts of the Performante is because of the design of the exhaust, when the valves are open and the car is up to operating temperature, you can actually see the catalytic converters glowing red at nighttime.
Look at that.
How are you? Long time no see. Last time I saw him, I was driving a right-hand drive supercharged R8 in London. And now we're back at the shop. Any chance you could tell me some differences between the Performante and the normal Huracan?
Absolutely. So apart from the cosmetics, the forged carbon fiber, you'll notice the exhaust has a rear center exit. So it's got this phenomenal design where at full throttle, when the valves actually open, the exhaust has a direct free flow. So it's almost like a straight through system. So we have one of the ALA ducts which sit on top of the airbox. And typically when the tailgate's closed, the engine compartment is lowered, this would come into connection as such. And the air from the top of the lid will be diverted on one side as it's closed to the top of the exhaust, so it's constantly cooling the exhaust through these vents. And the front active dam, the lower spoiler, has two motorized flaps. You can see this rectangular panel just here, and there's one on either side here. As the system is activated, the oncoming air, instead of going straight through and into the radiators, will actually, some of it will be diverted down and through and under the car. That's what gives it its extra downforce.
This guy literally bought this car and drove it from the dealership straight to VF to get it supercharged. What a champion. And because Lamborghini pre-brakes in the engines before they go in the cars, they realize that people don't drive Lamborghinis nearly as much as they should. So if somebody only puts 1500 miles on a car before they sell it and they have to drive it 1000 miles to break it in before that, then they're not gonna have any fun. So the car is fully broken in already. He's slapping a supercharger kit on a freaking Performante with like 20 miles on it. Props to the owner.
So when we supercharge it, we've encountered a number of differences, several hardware differences, so it's taken a little extra time. Mm-hmm. We went into this project thinking it was going to be a relatively straightforward project where we would just translate what we've learned on that 610 or the 580 Huracan and just apply it to the Performante, but it actually turned out to be quite the opposite. Several of the components are larger on the engine, which required some physical changes in the design of the kit, so we had to redraw them in CAD. And you can't actually see the components because those are underneath the supercharger manifold.
Okay, makes sense.
And then the airboxes are considerably different, and we've got a number of challenges with the software calibration. We found out sort of partway through the project, to our surprise, that the way the functions manage the data in the software is completely different. So we've had to explore several new strategies in fuel management, and we're still working through them. So it's taking a lot more time than we thought. It's very challenging. We enjoy these challenges. Mm-hmm. You know, we're also very keen to get these projects finished and get these cars on the road for spring.
Well, as much fun as looking at stationary Huracans that are turned off is, I think it's time to do some drifting. And by drifting, I mean, I'm not gonna be doing the drifting. Sam the pro is. Also, let's give some love to the LP560. I like the license plate too. That freaking rear diffuser is insane. Now you can get a supercharger for this too, 750 horsepower instead of 800, but I think it'll do. Sam is about to drift his supercharged Huracan into a parking spot between these two BMWs.
This is about to be insane. This reminds me of when me and you did the drift challenge in the snow, but we were drifting between cones, not two BMWs.
Yeah, we hit them.
Yeah, shoot.
This is actually insane. We've got a drone set up. We've got cameras everywhere. I've got faith in him. He can do it. All right, for the first shot, we're hiding in the car so that they can get a clean drone shot. I just realized, though, if anything goes wrong, I'm gonna get hit. What do you look at when you're about to drift in here?
First, I looked at the surface here because there's some surface changes here.
With yeah.
The, that's gonna upset a little bit the suspension and the way it's gonna go into the 90. So basically, you come up and you look for your gap. You look yep. where you wanna go. And then depending on the speed, that's determine when you pull the handbrake. Because if you pull the handbrake too early, you're gonna slow down and not get the full 90.
Sure, yeah.
If you're coming too hot, it's gonna go over 90. So it's all those things. And I don't know, the tires are cold, so this time it's all gonna be on the fly. I have to figure out, as I pull the handbrake, if the, I feel the car is going too slow, I can always give a little throttle to keep the momentum going
sure,
in the
sure.
Or, going a little too hot, I'm just have to wait for it to settle, and then I kind of let it go overnight and park it there. But you know, it's all about the feeling.
Yeah, well good luck, man. I'm sure you're gonna kill it. Wow. My God, that was insane. That was absolutely ridiculous. Good work.
Oh, thank you.
That was insane.
No, it's fun.
All right, my turn? I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Well, Samuel has decided that the parking spot drift wasn't good enough, so he's gonna do some more insanity.
Ready?
Well, as always, it's extremely exciting coming out to VF Engineering. We just showed up, didn't know what was gonna go on. Thanks for giving us a little tour. Thanks for your insane driving. Thanks for being you, Gary. Always just,
Gary's Gary.
He's a great guy. That was absolutely nuts. Now it is time to head to our buddy Ryan's shop, Protective Film Solutions, to see what they got going on there. This woman in the Prius is straight.
What?
Woman in the Prius was straight doing her makeup, and I think she saw that we were filming her doing such, and she just flipped us off as we drove by.
Did she flip you off?
Yeah, yeah, fully flipped us off. Hey. Now she's filming us. Maybe she's a vlogger too. Just showed up to Protective Film Solutions, and check this out. This was the Vorsteiner McLaren 570S that I reviewed a long time ago. They totally changed up the wrap, and I think they absolutely killed it. Let me know what you guys think of this, but look at the white wheels. This might be the coolest wrap I've actually ever seen. Look at the weathered McLaren logo. Whew. Yeah, this is absolutely incredible. Oh my gosh. It's such a good idea. All right, let's see what they got going on at PFS. What's up, man? Good to see you. By the way, McLaren wrap absolutely killed it. Like,
thank
unbelievable.
You. It's my favorite.
Blue 720S, C63, F12, and a freaking Chiron. Wow. All black carbon fiber, blue interior, blue calipers, and blue on the underside of the wing. Look at this interior, guys. This blue is spectacular. Lovely dry carbon, quilted leather, that beautiful LED light strip. I love the way the silver, black, and blue all work together.
Props to the owner of this car. Absolutely killed the spec.
Damon just pointed out these have to be some of the biggest, if not the biggest, front disc brakes on a car. That's amazing. At first, when you look at the car, it looks black, but it's actually exposed carbon fiber. Oh my God. 300 on the Speedo, you know, casual.
Hey, Damon.
Damon, look, Damon. Look, Damon, you're gonna laugh your ass off.
Oh.
Look at this fucker.
Oh my God.
You could do it over there.
Yeah, I didn't want to say
while I was here the whole time.
What else we got going on in the shop? We have a pretty much fully taken apart 488. We've got a Huracan, there's an M4, and a Tesla Model 3. Don't see too many of these, but they're popping up more and more. What do you guys think of the Model 3? For 35 grand, it's a pretty cool car. Damon, for my audience, can you explain the shirt? What?
It looks even better on white. We just didn't have any white t-shirts available.
So here's what's the deal with the shirt. Ryan moved locations.
Yep.
His previous location, when we first met and built our relationship, I was always known as the donut guy, right? So I'd bring my Huracan down, and the guys in this here would always go, Damon, will you do donuts for us? And it was okay on the old property. They didn't care. That back parking lot was cool. So when Ryan moved to this location, I said, can we do donuts? He goes, no, not here. And I said, okay, we won't do it here. And so I was in my car leaving, and he goes, you can't do it here, but you can do it over there. It's in my video.
Right? And now it's a shirt.
So I'm like, over where? Over there? He's like, yeah. So we went across the street, did donuts, and it was really bad. Because it was Ryan's opening day the next day. We didn't realize the neighbors were gonna get upset. I called, took total responsibility for the situation, apologized to him at least 1,000 times. I legitimately felt awful. I was actually legitimately at the time not invited to the grand opening. It was a bad situation.
Oh, I think I remember this.
Yeah, that's why I didn't come. And totally respectfully. And I called the people, the church, and they actually didn't care. It was the security guards that completely lost their Yeah, because I spoke to the president and everybody, and they were okay with it. This will haunt me for a while.
So you were saying you mostly do clear bras much more than wraps?
More clear bras than wraps. We still do a lot of wraps, but the majority is the clear bras. That's where we started.
Literally any hypercar that comes anywhere near the Southern California area, it comes here. It gets clear bra. It's freaking awesome. Yeah. This place is like the coolest car show in town, except it's their business and they're actually working on them the whole time. Oh, this is Rami's car?
We take everything off. And so everything is jammed, so we don't have any idea what the old color is anymore. All the way up to the doors and everything.
How long does a car like this take to wrap?
This one's 6 days.
Wow!
Because of the teardown.
That's fast.
Yeah, the teardown's miserable.
When I got my Gallardo wrapped, they teared it down and it took, like 4 weeks to do it. And by they, not them, somebody in Michigan.
Oh, you're starting it.
See, in the past, the Veyron had a little bit of a bad rap for not sounding that good, but oh my, did they fix that on the Chiron.
Oh. Yeah, like they're just immediately on. They didn't do the, it's just brighter. Interesting.
Here's a fun fact. I've just been informed that painting the calipers, how much do you think it could possibly cost to put some paint on the calipers of a Bugatti?
I'd be willing to bet $80,000.
Okay, you just heard him say that.
I'm in on that bet.
$80,000!
Look at the ground effects on the Chiron. Whew.
And being exposed carbon, it'll take two guys anywhere between 4 and 5 days to do it.
Yep.
And it's about 10-hour days.
Wow.
And there's no kit for it, so this is all done custom.
By hand, right? By hand. So when they're doing this, does anything come off the car? They do it all intact.
On the Chiron, we don't take much off.
Right.
Just because it doesn't really need it. The only thing that would have to come off on this car would be the mirrors and the door handles.
Yep.
And where the lines are, we don't need to. The only thing we don't do is on the back of the engine bay where the spine comes down the back.
Yep.
In order to do it, you'd have to have 4 or 5 seams and it would look horrible.
Yep.
So instead of doing the seams back there, we actually ceramic coat that area. So everything, the whole car is done with clear bra, and then we just do 4 to 5 layers of ceramic coating on there. And it still's protected, it doesn't get scratched, easy to clean. And if you get a rock chip back there, that means you've tipped your car over.
Fair enough.
So this will get done when we're all finished is we'll clean up the wheels and then we'll also put a ceramic coating on the wheels.
Wow.
We'll do it on the wheels, we'll do it on the calipers. It makes it so the dust doesn't stick to it. It'll stick to it when you look at it, but when you go to clean it, you spray it with water, do an air blower on it, and it's done. It doesn't water spot anymore, super easy, brake dust doesn't like it.
What would you do to protect the interior?
So there is a coating also for the interior. There's one for carpeting, there's one for vinyl, there's one for leather. So each one of them has its own separate product.
Okay.
And definitely gonna wanna do it on this. As you can see with that baby blue that's in here, any little thing is gonna stain it.
Right.
And I couldn't imagine what it would cost to replace a seat cover on a Chiron. I'm thinking 10 or 20 bucks.
Yeah.
Per square millimeter.
Yeah. Where would someone go to pick it up if they weren't from Southern California? Could they order it from you and have it shipped?
Yeah, they can order it from us. It's definitely not a user installable, as if anybody that wanted to, you'd want to have it done professionally installed.
Okay.
Just contact us and we can tell you who near you would be able to do it for you.
And then at the back of the car, anything special for just users or anything like that?
Nothing really special. Just continuing, as you can see, we're right in the middle of doing the install right there. So the film, the film's just drying out right now before we'll start to roll the edges. And other than that, it's that. We'll just continue everything. We don't put film on the lights. It's not needed, but we do ceramic coat the lights.
Okay.
Just we want to make it so they don't scratch.
So I've got a question for you. You're just talking to Damon about doing partial wrap. So my Huracan has just the front of it and the rear quarter panels with X-Bel. I noticed after a while it starts to get kind of gunked up and damaged. How hard is it to remove it?
There's a right way and a wrong way to remove it.
What's the wrong way?
Wrong way is just kind of ripping it off like a Band-Aid or doing it when it's cold. The best way to do it is with a steamer.
Wow.
It's the only right way to do it.
Yeah.
It's designed not to burn you.
Wow, that's impressive.
It's heated at a good temperature where it just gets the material warm, loosens up the adhesive, and it allows you to pull it off. When you use a steamer, it's not really bad to take off. It's still time consuming,
yeah.
But you're not gonna rip paint, you're not gonna damage your clear coat.
So this is a funny story. I have a friend who has a E46 M3 he bought used. Took the wrap off himself in like middle of winter for all paint off.
Oh, absolutely.
Like literally down to the metal. He goes, I hate wraps. I'm like, nah, I think he did something wrong.
So now do you use the steam gun to put the wrap on as well? Or do you use a heat gun for that?
We use this sometimes. Heat gun just sometimes is too hot.
Gotcha.
We use the heat guns for the wraps, the vinyls. That's where you want the heat.
And how much thinner is a clear film than a vinyl wrap?
You gotta figure like the spell film is 8 mils.
Uh-huh.
Where vinyl is around 2-2.5 mils, so it's quite a bit different, but
wow.
Completely different animals.
Yeah.
This one's engineered to take rock chips.
Sure.
To get just the hell beat out of it. Where vinyl is to look pretty.
Yeah.
So it's thin, it's not made to last a long period of time, and it's also made to remove really easy. Now the vinyl wrap, like our Marlboro one,
yeah,
that's pretty thick. That's
gotcha.
Probably gonna be right around the 8 mil. Thickness by the time we actually more because we do have it wrapped with clear, so that's probably 13 mils.
Yeah.
13, 14 mils.
Now, how impressive is this? You said that you did that wrap in one day.
So we printed it and then we started it in the morning, and at the end of the day, it was done. How would you say the curves are where they need to be?
Sure.
Yeah, so it was a one day wrap on that car.
So if that's an easy car, what's the hardest car to wrap?
488.
And why is that?
Everything's in the wrong spot.
I knew it. Pininfarina leaves and they can't, it's impossible to wrap. Well, thank you so much. It's always a huge pleasure coming out to Protective Film Solutions.
Hold on. It's gonna be okay. And then, I'm not installing this, but at Protective Film Solutions, this is where they legit install this stuff on multi-million dollar cars. I can only imagine how many people are like, there's no way Damon's about to install clear raw. No, I'm not.
I thought you were about to do that. I was like, wait, did you get like approval from anyone before you're gonna stick that on the car? Oh, this thing is so gorgeous. Well, if you guys haven't followed Daily Driven Exotics yet, I'm not really sure what you're doing, but this dude just tried attempting to wrap a Bugatti Chiron. So like, you gotta watch this video. So link in the description below, Daily Driven Exotics.
Yeah, what did you order,
that
dude?
On fire.
That suit was literally fire.
I've never seen anything like that before, have you?
No.
Good luck with that.
Yeah, eat around.
Oh God. DDE testing out their new A9 camera. Can I see?
That's so ridiculous.
Actually quite jealous of his setup.
Got on the dial, it says S and Q, and that's where you can change
supercharges,
slow motion, or time lapse.
Wow. See, it's amazing the difference in equipment that everyone uses on YouTube. Street Speed uses a GoPro, Doug DeMiro uses an iPhone, I've got a Canon 5D and a G7X, he's got an A9, Ewan Olsen use a red camera or something crazy.
Did for a bit, and he had the pass on a GH5 or whatever.
Hold on, Doug DeMiro uses an iPhone?
Yeah, man.
No.
Yep.
There you go, kids, want to start a channel?
He has the most views out of
it. Yeah, literally, yeah, darn it, Doug. You can see Dave's having a great time with this collaboration.
Hello.
Back near my old stomping grounds in Santa Monica, these fools have an important business meeting over Nobu. I mean, I'm freaking jealous. I've never even been to Nobu and I live here.
Nobu and Malibu, and they're buying.
I wasn't invited.
Well, these fools are gonna get some awesome meal without me, and I'll see you in a second.
This is what?
Dab on the haters.
Yep.
Okay, Jake.
Well, they had a meeting at Nobu. I decided to be productive and went to the gym. I am feeling great. Obviously, haven't made any progress yet, but getting my butt in the gym and actually sticking to my New Year's resolution, I'm pretty excited about it. They just texted me. They're on their way back. All right, well, the boys just got back.
Why are you yelling?
You're always yelling right here.
Freaking camera.
We're right here.
Why just
right
I just what?
The camera's
I'm excited right here, but bro.
Holy turn down the tone.
All right, well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Subscribe to Daily Driven Exotics if you haven't already. This guy's a freaking fiend. He drives, what do you do?
Oh, boom, right boom, there.
Boom. Smash that subscribe button.
Right there.
I want to see 300K. Whoa, wow, you're going to break your computer. Could be worth it, though, for 300,000 subs. And then we got Dave over here. I mean, you know.
He doesn't have
a we're not sure quite what Dave does. And then,
Don't even say it.
All right, well, seriously, guys, I hope you enjoyed today's content. Smash that thumbs up button. Subscribe to the channel. Subscribe to them. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow.
What happened in the next video?
I don't know. I was just like, we're still rolling. It was next video, but next video is tomorrow, and I don't know. Boom. All right, we're calling it quits. Peace.